for posterity. No, my phone went off in the middle of the internet there. Start over. And this time we're going to see it from the bottom. Whole match from my point of view. So we have an overview and then my view. Somehow didn't get splattered by a hammer, and yet got the hammer. You never predict these things. Also, I believe this is my current set that I've been playing with. Where the abilities are focused on the Slayer weapon, rather than just being basically it focuses on being a Slayer rather than purely anything else. Respawn Punisher, quick respawn. A little bit of nickname to help save that. Well, to help make the main weapon at least a little bit more useful for various other modes. Something to resist. From the side. Always a good tactic. I mean, you gotta get in really close when you're a Splatoon, but you know. This is the bit that really bothered me. Got beaten by a crab tank by getting hit by it. That was that match. So many things went wrong with how I did things, but also so many things went right. It was just literally a head counterplay to it. Guaranteed. That was this one. We'll play this battle replay. Another one we're gonna take. Aerial view. So we're just gonna see how I end up doing things here. And you know, how things work out. I'll do some more recordings of these sessions, like, up close, but really what I'm going to do is I'm going to focus more on really the overhead, because the overhead kind of, it's a decent picture of what goes on, and what I end up focusing on the most with the attack. It was pretty nice though. This is a pretty good match. I think what really mattered the most was the respawn punisher coming in handy. Boom! Like this one. So this was all done like in the morning just before work. I think it was yesterday. Actually, I'm pretty sure this was all like either just yesterday or like on Wednesday. It was recent. And that was why I popped that there, because I was like, okay, you need to make sure to come back this way. So, I'm using one side over there for a bit, and then we just move right on it. Splatted over there. The rest of my team is just still alive because they're just holding it all down. They're not trying to move hard forward anywhere or anything. I get splatted in the zone. And then the rest of the team is like, okay, well, you need to stay out of the zone now. Thank you. I come back in, and we resume moving forward. That's how it worked. Hagglefish must be my best to play when it comes to using this weapon, because I just generally seem to do well with it. But now I have Museum de Alfonsino, there's two other ways as well, so like, I'm betting it's just a team comp, really. So there's that hacklefish, which I think that's the one who just wheel hooked it. It's weird when there are two matches that are the same colors, though. Play this replay. Yeah, this is a completely different team comp. Oh, right. But we've already heard this song. We've already seen that one. So this is the next one to watch. Sorry for me just kind of being quiet, retrospective here. Old match, just reviewing the whole thing. Also mainly for posterity of, you know, saving good gameplay I did. Where I actually was doing good. Rather than bad. See, I'm already in their base. Straight off the bat with Alfonsino. And that makes one of them jump back out, and then he just kind of, because I spent enough time distracting them, getting them scared, they just kind of don't leave. Not immediately, at least. they go out of their way, but they have to go deal with me. But I think that's what ends up happening throughout the whole match, where I just kind of go in. Because they're focusing at me, I can focus back at them. And just slow them down. Also helps the rest of the team is like, huh, we have a good Slayer on our hands. That's it right there. Also my favorite color. Just gonna say right now, this is one of my favorite colors. The moon debris. Pin that one. Play this replay. We end up going back to Anglefish. Same foursome. Going. Gotta watch the left side because that's where I'm at. Yeah, this was the group that gave us quite a bit of a run for a while. And I mean, like, what else do you think can happen? I mean, I got caught having to do some cleanup. Was the issue. And of course in our time it started with the team, we were just like, cleanup is annoying. The rest of my team was like, yeah, it's annoying. But we had to keep doing it because otherwise mobility was an issue. This was also where I went, okay, you know what? Whoever it is doing this over here, stop it. Gonna stop them right now, besides. And they stopped me. I took that guy out and cleaned up a bit. This just really goes hard. This is where we got the. We almost lost it completely because it was so close. And we're just like, nope. We want to keep that lead. Keep that lead. And that was genuinely all we wanted out of it. Press strike tries to slow us down. We're like, nope. Nope. And it's funny because as a unified group, we think this wouldn't really work great, but we definitely kept them on their toes. And I kept looking for chances to either splat or force them out of the area. This is where I got angry too. I recognized that moment. And then I was just like, nuh-uh, nope. No, angry. I'm ready to make this happen. So I focused myself on doing the rest of this other stuff. Going around. Go up. Show them no mercy. And get splatted for it. That's where you gotta remember. Don't tilt. Bad things happen to you when you tilt. We did, however, still get a knockout easy. This is why you don't tilt. And it's funny because this I really loved because these people, whoever they were, played so well together with me. What I like more is that they learned how quickly I just want to get into the battle. And just went, okay. You let Xara get splatted and see where everyone is, or, you know, let things play out. And for this one, we actually had a long comeback that happened. It actually took us quite a bit. And it's mainly because I actually took my time trying to get these people. Two over there, gone. Then I come over here, start inking. Now the main reason for why we need an ink. And it's funny because the good guys are the cyan color goop. We're the bad guys, technically, for this one. And I still loved doing this. Versus Ink. I feel really sorry for, what's his name down at the bottom. Because Hope is just trying to keep Hope alive, and Jenny, oh. Is it Tico? Yeah, Tico. Tico with his jet squelchers. There's no exit because there's no Neo yet. Dual jet squelchers. This is where, again, I get into the base. I start messing with their perceptions of this. Because I keep one person locked over there. Keeping it a 3-on-3. And then I take down one of them. But, you know, thought he'd be able to slip right on by me. Nope. Then I take down those two there as well. And this is where we just completely clean it out. Because we have played enough mind games and enough fighting, so to speak, that we were able to lock them out for a bit. Alright. So that's all of those videos. I'm gonna upload this as a thing, just a small compilation of everything that happens. And you guys can enjoy it then.